Now to the UK, where British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak has announced a general election for July. Now, it was weird to say the least. The media strategy appeared to be, let's put Sunak out in the rain for some reason, while activists trolled him with the Labour-winning campaign song from the 1997 election.
Now is the moment for Britain to choose its future, to decide whether we want to build on the progress we have made or risk going back to square one with no plan and no certainty.
So what were the media minders thinking? And it wasn't the only bizarre decision. At Sunak's campaign launch, a Sky UK journalist was thrown out by bouncers.
This is where the Prime Minister is going to speak in the next few minutes, and I'm being forcibly removed. We just simply wanted to have access tonight at Sky News, but unfortunately, we're told that because there are pool arrangements in place, we're not allowed to be here. This is, by the way, what we're trying to film is the campaign event where the Prime Minister is due to speak in the next couple of minutes. It's in front of Conservative activists. It's eventually trying to get across the message that we had in Downing Street today.
Well, Sophie, nothing says open and transparent governance like a pair of bouncers hauling journalists onto the street. Very strange scenes. What do you make of it all?
Well, it doesn't look good, does it, when you've got a journalist being carted out by security guards and they've got footage of it, rolling footage of it. A PR nightmare, looks extremely bad for the government, whatever the circumstances, whether or not the journalist should have been there or not. This is a very bad look, but it's for a government that is already under siege, and I think they've got pretty much zero chance at the upcoming election.
Yeah, Tim, that's a good point. Every poll, every single poll in the last couple of months shows that they are on track to be completely wiped out. It almost looks like they've given up. It looks like maybe the top media minders have gone and looked for another job. They don't want to be associated with it. But that, to me, did not look like a man who thinks that he can genuinely win an election.
No, it looks like, you know, one of the wealthiest politicians in UK history can't afford an umbrella or can't hire someone to hold one. I mean, it's always a risky game, I guess, in British politics to make that big decision, let's go outside, when you're in London. Not 5 times out of 10 it's going to backfire on you. It's a real coin toss. I would say about the bouncer issue, the hired goon, all credit to the reporter for just keeping talking. As you and Sophie know, First rule of media, when a camera's on, don't shut up. Don't betray any panic. Just keep, and there were no ums or ahs. He just kept going on. He told his story, even as the goon advanced him down the hallway. It was impressive work.